Hi children, good morning. Now we will learn the continuation of previous class, rounding of numbers. Okay, now I will explain rounding of numbers. Rounding of numbers to the nearest tens. To the nearest tens. Okay. So now we should write numbers from 80 to 90. 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90. So now round up 87, 81, 85. Eighty-one is nearer to 80 than 90. So 81 will be rounded off to 80. Next 87. 87 is nearest to 90 than 80. So 87 will be rounded off to 90. Okay. Next 85. So 85 is near to 80 or 90. 85 is at equal distance from 80 and 90. But by convention, it is nearest to 90. Okay. So, 81 equal to 80. 87 equal to 90. 85 equal to 90. Okay. So, once again, to the nearest tens. Rounding of numbers to the nearest tens. Okay, 80 to 90 numbers are given. So here 81 is rounded, 87 is rounded, 85 is rounded. 81 is nearest to 80 than 90. Means 81 will be rounded to 80. 87 is nearest to 90. So 87 will be rounded up to 90. But 85 is at equal distance from 80 and 90. But by convention, it is rounded up to 90. So, this is the example for rounding of numbers to the nearest tens. Next. Rounding of numbers to the nearest hundreds. To the nearest hundreds. To the nearest hundreds. To the nearest hundreds. Suppose we should write 200 to 300. 200, 210, 220, 230, 240. 250, 260, 270, 280, 290, 300. Okay. So, we are rounded 220, 280 and 250. Okay. So, 220. 220 is nearest to 200. So, 220 will be rounded up to 200. Next, 280 is nearest to 300. So, 280 will be rounded up to 300. Once again, 220 is nearest to 200 than 300. So, 220 will be rounded up to 200. Next, 280 is nearest to 300 than 200. So, 280 will be rounded up to 300. What is the rounding of number is 250 by 250. 250 is at equal distance from 200 to and 300. So 250 is by the convention it is rounded up to 300. So 220 equal to 200, 280 equal we will tell always 250 is nearer to 300. Similarly, you have to do rounding up numbers to the nearest thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs. Okay, so this is the nearest hundreds. Have you understood rounding of numbers to the nearest tens and nearest hundreds? Have you understood children? Any doubt? So similarly, you have to do rounding of numbers, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, etc. Okay? So this is the rounding of numbers. Topic is completed. Next, we are going to next topic, place value. You have already learnt how to expand the numbers using place value. Recall how you expand a 2-digit number, a 3-digit number, a 4-digit number and a 5-digit number. Now we will discuss expansion form of larger numbers. Let us take the number. This is the 7-digit number. These are called larger numbers. Okay. So every number has expansion form and expanded form. So first, its expansion form. So this is place value. So we know Indian place value system. Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs. Okay. 7 in 10 lakhs place. 5 is in lakhs place. 9 is in 10 thousands place. 6 is in thousands place. 4 is in hundreds place. 5 is in tens place. 7 is in ones place. So how to write expansion form? See. 7 into 10 lakhs plus 5 into 1 lakh plus 9 into 10,000 plus 6 into 1000 plus 4 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 7 into 1. This is the expansion form of the given number. Next, its expanded form. Is that 70 lakh plus 5 lakh plus 90,000 plus 6,000 plus 400 plus 50 plus 7. So this is the expansion form and expanded form of the larger numbers. Have you understood? So listen once again. So place value. So the given number 75,96,457. We know place value. Okay. So this is ones place, tens place, hundred place, thousands place, ten thousands place, lakhs place, 10 lakhs place. So every number has expansion form and expanded form. So its expansion form is, the given number's expansion form is 7 into 10 lakhs plus 5 into 1 lakh plus 9 into 10,000 plus 6 into 1,000 plus 4 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 7 into 1. This is the expansion form. Next, it's expanded form. 70 lakhs plus 5 lakh plus 90,000 plus 6,000 plus 400 plus 50 plus 7. So this is the expanded form and expansion form. So similarly, you have to do 6 digit larger numbers, 7 digit, 8 digit, 9 digits. So like this. Okay, understood? Place value, expansion form and expanded form. Okay, now we will go to next topic. Use of commas. Use of commas. So we know Indian place value system. So how to keep commas in Indian system. So here, suppose one number is given without commas. How to keep the commas in Indian system? Okay. So in our Indian system of numeration, we use ones, tens, hundreds, ten thousands, lakhs, crores. The commas are used to mark hundreds, thousands, lakhs and crores. So first, let us take the number without commas. So this is the number, this is the given number. How to keep the commas in Indian system, in Indian place value system? We know Indian place value system, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, ten lakhs, crores, ten crores. Okay, so first, the first comma comes after hundreds place. The first comma comes after hundred place. So first, this direction is right side of the given number. This direction is left side of the given number. Okay. First, the first comma comes after hundreds place. Next, second comma comes after 10,000's place. Third comma comes after 10 lakhs place and mark lakhs. Okay, now this is the system of commas. Okay, how to read this number? So, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore, 10 crores. 75 crores, 43,000, 43 lakhs, 19,482. Okay, now? So, use of commas in Indian system. Okay. So, use of commas help us in reading and writing larger numbers easily. Okay, next, see one example. Seven crore, fifteen lakh, twenty thousand, and five hundred. Can be written as seven crore. 15 lakh, 20,000, 500. Okay, now? So, commas help us in reading and writing larger numbers easily. Okay, now? So, next, I will give one number. how to read. Similarly, we can easily read, which is separated by commas. No. So, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, lakhs, ten lakhs, crores, ten crores, 19 crores, 76 lakhs, 7,159. This number is separated by commas, means we can read easily. Okay. So, this is use of commas. So, this topic is also completed. To get perfection on yesterday's and today's topic, you should solve exercise 1.1 and 1.2. Okay. We shall discuss remaining topics tomorrow.